Because studies are the building block of systematic reviews, the WWC needs a definition for what constitutes a study. In practice, a single manuscript, such as a journal article or report, might include more than one study, or multiple manuscripts might all report on the same study. So, drawing a line to distinguish one study from another can be challenging. When analyses of the same intervention share certain characteristics, the WWC considers them parts of the same study. These study characteristics include the study sample. This is the set of students, classrooms, teachers, or schools that the study analyzed. Findings from analyses that include some or all of the same sample members may be related. The assignment or selection process used to create the intervention and comparison groups in the study sample. A random assignment process is one way of creating the study sample. Another way is to form groups by matching students who received the intervention to comparison students who did not. The data collection and analysis procedures used to produce the findings. When authors use identical or nearly identical procedures to collect and analyze data, the findings may be related. The research team that conducted the study. When manuscripts share one or more authors, the findings reported in those manuscripts may be related. When two findings on the effectiveness of the same intervention share at least three of these characteristics, the WWC considers them parts of the same study. Findings that meet this criterion demonstrate similarity or continuity in the intervention and comparison groups, and similarity or continuity in the procedures used to produce the findings. Let's consider a few scenarios to help clarify how the WWC defines a study. First, consider a manuscript that presents a finding based on combining data across related samples, such as those from multiple time periods within the same school. For example, imagine that the researchers randomly assigned classrooms within a middle school to conditions, and the same intervention is implemented in the intervention classrooms over several school years. The study examines the effectiveness of the intervention in three consecutive cohorts of students in the middle school and measures the effectiveness of the intervention based on each cohort separately, but using the same analytic procedures. In this case, the WWC would review all the findings in the manuscript as a single study because they share all four of the study characteristics. The study samples in each cohort were formed within the same school. The same random assignment process was used for each cohort. The researchers used the same data collection and analysis procedures, and the same research team was responsible for all of the findings. Now, imagine that instead of reporting the combined findings in one manuscript, the authors released a series of reports, each reporting a single year finding. These findings again share all four characteristics, so the WWC would review the series of reports as a single study. The fact that the authors released the findings separately in different reports does not affect how the WWC reviews the findings. Now consider a journal article that reports on the effectiveness of an algebra curriculum on student scores on a standardized math assessment. The study conducted a randomized control trial, RCT, in New Jersey schools, and a quasi-experimental design, QED, in Wisconsin schools. Although the authors report findings for both samples in the same journal article, both the sample members and the assignment process differ in the two samples. Because the findings share fewer than three of the characteristics, the WWC would review the RCT and QED as two separate studies. It's time for our first knowledge check. Knowledge check 1. Which of the following is not included in a review protocol? A. Eligible outcome measures. B. Specific approaches to use for areas of discretion in the WWC design standards, such as the attrition threshold and the characteristics that studies may use to satisfy the baseline equivalence requirement. C. Population of interest, including age or grade ranges. D. A citation list of all eligible studies. E. Sources to use in the search for eligible studies. D is the correct answer. The review protocol does not include a citation list of all eligible studies. Instead, the protocol identifies the criteria studies must meet to be eligible. After conducting a literature search using the search terms and methods outlined in the protocol, the WWC screens studies for eligibility using the review protocol. A, B, C, and E are incorrect answers. The review protocol describes the scope and parameters of the review, including eligible outcome measures, the attrition threshold, the population of interest, and details related to the literature search. Knowledge check 2. True or false? If a reviewer assigns a does not meet WWC design standards rating to a study, then the study review is complete. The statement is false. In addition to at least one certified reviewer, a senior member of the review team looks at all eligible studies that are within the scope of a particular WWC review. If the first reviewer assigns a rating of does not meet WWC design standards to the study, a senior member of the review team will review the study and attempt to confirm the rating. If the senior member of the review team does not confirm the rating, a second reviewer will independently review the study, and all three staff members will work together to determine the rating.